In the breakdown of the supplementary request, the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development is seeking for approval of a supplementary budget of 2 billion shillings that facilitated renovation works at the Gaddafi National Mosque, despite a recent court order putting up the property for sale in order to facilitate the recovery of 19 billion shillings debt the Uganda Muslim Supreme Council owes businessman Justice Chabahwa.
We are going to scrutinize and see whether that expenditure meet these two requirements, that the expenditure was unavoidable by the time they were spending it, although it was unforeseeable when we were planning and when the government was presenting the budget at this time.
The Uganda Development Corporation, UDC, is seeking for approval of additional 37 billion shillings that was lent to businessman Sudhiru Pareria to construct Munyonyo Convention Center to host the Non-Aligned Movement Summit. Despite a recent pronouncement by the government to sell Soroti Fruit Factory to a private investor, the Uganda Development Corporation, UDC, is seeking for 9.467 billion shillings for the struggling entity. Uganda Broadcasting Corporation, UBC, is also lined up for 24.883 billion shillings for its revamp, while Uganda Prisons is seeking for 79.471 billion shillings to feed inmates across the various prisons.
I have observed as a scholar of political economy that in Uganda we are making unrealistic budgets. I'm a member of the budget committee. I'm a member of a sectoral committee on trade, industry and cooperatives. That's a very big program. So I can say with confidence of what I'm talking about.
Is there a good justification for the supplementary budget? Because the supplementary should be coming because something was not foreseen. The budget, that one must be something which was unforeseeable.
State House is seeking for 100 billion shillings for classified expenditure, while the Ministry of Defense is seeking for Parliament's approval to spend 1 billion shillings for the construction of the military museum, and the Ministry of Public Service wants 12.98 billion shillings for the payment of arrears for Moneylenders Association. Another controversial expenditure in the supplementary budget is a request by the Minister of Health to spend 2.7 billion shillings on the supervision costs for Lubowa Hospital, while the same Ministry of Health is seeking for 22.934 billion shillings for payment of arrears for medical interns.
The classified budget has been increasing year in, year out. Actually, the classified budget is bigger than almost all the budgets, or sometimes even bigger than the budget of infrastructure, for example. But this classified budget definitely is just for patronage.
Most of the classified is under State House. And State House has been around for some time. They know their nature of business. They can forecast and have this money within, even if it is within classified, but it should be within the budget, not within classified and under supplementary.
Ministry of Lands, Housing and Urban Development has lined up 5 billion shillings for compensation of some cultural institutions, including Kabaka Land, 2 billion shillings, compensation for Bunyoro Kingdom, 1 billion shillings, compensation for Toro Kingdom, 2 billion shillings, while Uganda's mission in Iran is looking for approval of 166.5 million shillings that was spent on repatriation of the body of the late Ambassador Muhammad Kisambira. In May this year, Parliament passed a 52.7 trillion budget for the financial year 2023-2024, with only 25.1 trillion shillings available for discretionary expenditure. If this supplementary schedule is approved, it will stretch the financial year budget to 56.2 trillion shillings. The Minister of Finance is expected to appear before the Parliamentary Budget Committee tomorrow to justify the request for supplementary expenditure. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.